All right, I'm going to be setting up a solar panel with a battery and a controller, and this is to run the vent fan, which will be actually inside of the root cellar. Out here on top, I'm going to have the solar panel there, and I have some cable wire that will run down the pipe here, and then we'll connect to the controller and then on to the battery to charge the battery. Anyway, that's the plan for this part of the root cellar project. Right here, I've already drilled in the hole for the vent pipe, and so now I'm sticking the wires down through the vent pipe. Right out. There's my two wires that slid down. Okay, so here is the controller, and so we're going to put on the back those wires that I just slipped down, and so that'll come from the solar panel into the solar panel connectors here, and then this will be the battery, and so this will go to the battery and charge the battery, and then from the battery we'll have another set of wires that will go up to the actual vent fan, and that will turn it on. Okay, so I have the controller set up here, and so it's charging right now. It's going to be charging this marine battery that I have in the corner, and that marine battery will be used to power the vent fan, which is right here. And so I got the wires right here, and I need to hook that up still so they can go down to the marine battery, and we should be good to go. So that'll keep. I'm probably only going to put this vent fan every once in a while, not all the time. I've heard that these fans wear out if you run them continuously. The bearings get bad or something like that, but anyway, I'll probably just run it every once in a while just to get some ventilation in here. We'll see. I mean, I'm definitely, when I'm down here, it probably would be good to have that vent and just air out the place and give you a lot of fresh air versus the natural flowing of air, which is probably not as much. I'm thinking the fan will probably also lower the humidity because it'll be circulating that air, taking the humid air out, bringing drier air in. And so at least I can control the level of humidity that I want in here at any given time. Here's a close look at the controller. You can see my marine battery is 75% charged right now, according to it. I heard that these aren't super, super accurate with regard to the measuring device here, but it gives you an idea of where it's at. Actually, this marine battery here has been charging on the solar panel outside with a different controller, so I would have thought it would have been closer to 100%, but it's nice to see that everything's working there. Well, I went for some supplies and I came back, and it's already 100% on the charge indicator there, so it is working. That's good. And right down there I have an inverter for the light here, and so the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get these wires and hook that up to the battery so that I got a vent working. Oh, yeah. No problem. All right, so right down here, it's a little loud though, in my opinion. for a vent fan. I mean, some vent fans are loud, but it's definitely not quiet. I'm going to show you. There's actually some air coming out of it. Here's a bag. Definitely got air coming through. That's great. All right. Oh, that's good. That's a lot of air. Good throughput. Anything, it's working. And it feels a lot less humid in here now. Okay, so here's on top. And you can see the... I put a screen here to prevent bugs from getting in. So I just use some window screening. And so hopefully that'll keep all the critters out. And I need to put one over here, but I don't have one of the brackets, one of the these guys. So I need to get another one of those. And I'm going to cut a 3/4 inch plywood for the top here for now. I still need to put some more of the weather stripping around it. You can see it's coming up. I need to put some washers where you see the screws there, so that it's less likely for that to come up. Okay. There we go. Alright, that's gonna lie flatter than the other one. And I'm gonna probably put on some roofing material, maybe some roll roofing, to keep the water from touching the wood. But that's about right, so that's what I'm going to use for now. I may come up with a different system later, but that's going to work pretty good, I think. Well, that looks good. So we got a nice tight seal on the door here. And it'll be pretty easy to open and close. It's actually a pretty heavy door. It's that 3/4 inch plywood. So having those hinges really helps. I'll be unscrewing these guys once I put on some roofing material, and then I'll put it back so that I have that feature. You see right down here, there's some screws that went through. They're not actually touching the seal, they're on the outside. So it's actually works perfectly. It doesn't, it's not going to get damaged by those screws. So that's good. Nice tight fit. Well, I got the roofing on, but the one hiccup is that the shingle roofing flips out when I swing the door on its back. I was planning to use rolled roofing, but the cost was twice as much, so in the end I decided to just nail the shingles to the plywood to prevent it from dangling. I may have to put some sealant on the nails, but we'll see how it weathers for now. That's the end of this video. I appreciate your continued viewings on my videos, and hope to see some comments from you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.